records that you can actually buy. But even that, that's still like in the 80s, 70s. I hate going back to this time. You could money, it wasn't that you couldn't save for it, like even down to everyone doing that whole, you know, every month everyone puts some donations in.
Providence. It's hey, you like the, you say, you lot's, whose parents knows about Providence.
Which, you know, was susu, isn't it? That, you know,
just, oh, gonna, mommy.
If we're going to put some, you know, this month we're making contributions, 500 that we're going to be putting into this month, and the next month then we'll do another 6. So gradually by the end of the year, that Sister Grace can now buy her home.
Stepped outside and she was walking by. Usually zoned out, but she caught my eye. My eyes looking at them thighs and then she looked surprised. She said, you're all the same. I replied, I ain't surprised. With them looks, mama do 180s, like left foot's connected. Like bodies in bed when the set's good. Interested, yeah, I see you are, but what to do about this? Put your name and number down, three, a couple different outfits.
Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to you wherever and whenever you are watching this video. It's us. Last few episodes of Bench Banter for 2022. What are we on now? What do you say? What are we on now?
Episode 8.
Episode 8. Yes, yes. We're bringing you episode 8 of Bench Banter. It's me. You know who I be. The one and only Mandele. Obviously, I'm out here with my brother, the one and only legend, the man that is
Cranberry Juice.
Cranberry Juice.
Not even orange. Not even. Not even. No, I can't be OJ. Fair play, innit?
And obviously, you are locked in to Bench Banter.
That's it. That's it.
It's easy.
It's crazy out in these streets. Fucking a lot of us are going through shit out here, man. What are we calling it? The quarter life crisis. Quarter life crisis. A lot of us are just kind of, I don't know, man. You speak to a lot of people our age. A lot of us are kind of in similar positions. Just kind of
confused,
trying to survive. Just going through the motions. Do you know what I mean? You genuinely believe there is like a mass wave of this supposed quarter life crisis going on?
I don't know, sometimes I feel like I'm going through it. Not accomplished. In a sense, like, you know, by your, let's say your 30s, 40s, you should be somewhere that you're happy. Mm. You know? I don't know, it's challenging to
even say. But you feel like there is pressure in society to kind of be in certain positions by the time you're 30, do you know what I mean? It's like so much is expected of us to have been done by the time we're 30 that do you feel like it's still realistic? Like house, kids, wife, dog, car, 2 cats.
All those things.
Come on. Oh, is it a rap?
It's a rap.
Yeah, I want to hear a rap. I want to hear a rap.
A little singing version.
Yeah, well, I'd love to hear it.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm the man with the maddest touch. Yeah. The man with the maddest touch.
Hey.
And it's stupid lyrics.
Yeah.
Wish I hadn't wrote it now.
What, you wrote it?
That finished in the 2000s, man. Mm. I'm sorry to say, but that way of living and thinking, that should have been out of the minds of many
so
from 2000. Because there's a new way of and ways, new style of
what
living.
What would you say the new style of thinking is?
Conveniently. Mm. Living conveniently. And it's hard because we've built up to living this convenient life that now we're feeling economic pressures. Now things are not so convenient as well now. Mm. But also even the fact that, I don't know what, let's say our parents went through, but I guess in their time it was like policy and rules where you can only do this, so you must like what you fucking do.
Mm.
Do you know what I'm saying? now we have it all. Our parents have told us we can be anything we want, and we've never given it a thought as to what truly we want to be. But some of us. And
do you think our parents even understand the struggle that we're going through? I feel like they think they had it way harder than we have it. But I feel like we have it as equally as hard as them, but it's just a different kind of hard. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
What was we saying the other day at Ricky's? Like they were playing it on
hard, but we're playing it on crushing.
We're playing it on crushing, bro.
Playing like on crushing right now. It's crazy, and this is why I feel like this whole quarter life crisis is happening to, especially people of our age, kind of thing, because it's not more so what society thinks, but more so what we're thinking, where we want to be, where. How we're gonna get there? Things that we should have done in our past. Oh, we can't do it now.
Yeah,
there's not enough time.
Yeah, feels like there's not enough time, man.
I think, yeah, because the world has never been as rich as how it is now. Yeah. Back in those days, seeing a Ferrari, or like these big RS6s and stuff, nice cars. It was for some that was even an outing. Do you know what I'm saying? To go out and see all them things.
Yeah, yeah. You but now, see them in ends, innit?
Now you see them parked up and stuff. So you start thinking to yourself, rah. Like, you know, honestly, it's attainable. But it's not attainable in the sense that it's not sustainable. So it really isn't attainable.
But what makes it not sustainable?
Listen, there's some things that we have. Okay, let's say, in fact... If it's not an asset, then it's not sustainable. Let's be crude about it. If it's not an asset, it's not sustainable.
I hear that, yeah.
Since I was like, I don't know, like 11 or something like that. And then I trained at an independent drama school.
But it's hard to define what is considered.
It depends
an asset
on what you make.
I feel like everyone just when people think about assets, people just automatically go to property. Though, don't you feel like that?
Yeah.
Like property is probably what else can we own in this world that could constantly generate us money other than property?
Yeah, but even property still, it's only an asset when it's finished, when it's been bought, when it's complete, purchase is done.
Like, no, but even owning like one of these flats, bro. If you owned it, that's an asset. I feel like an asset is, you know.
Nah, man.
You don't think?
Nah, man.
One of these flats here,
one
bro.
Of these things you have to actually it could be, because if you own it, then, but it's a lease. So
no, but you can't like own it as in I own it. You can never buy one of these, do you reckon?
A lot of the time, no.
Oh, for real?
No. Because the landlord, the person that's built this,
they own the whole complex.
And he says, okay, cool, if you want to own your house, I might give you a percentage of it, but just factor in, if there is repairs that need to be done, you got to pay for it.
You got to chip in.
That's what happens. So you can own a fraction of it, but you can't own it. Unless it's a freehold, a full windows, door, garden kind of, you know,
that's the only kind of property you can own.
Yeah. As in, I mean, you can own, I think housing associations now give you options to, you know, do right to buys and stuff. Yeah. But again, it's a lease, you know.
Sorry.
Fuck you, mate.
Sorry.
Fuck you. What the fuck are you doing?
So I crashed.
What do you mean you crashed? I just hit my head.
Sorry.
No, stay there. I'll call the police.
Okay.
Don't go anywhere.
I'm not.
Don't go anywhere.
I'm not. I'm sitting on my
Don't
back.
Don't go anywhere. Don't go anywhere.
Okay. Look, I'm getting off.
Is it bleeding?
No.
Yeah, don't go anywhere.
Oh,
bank won't even pressure with asking you the likelihood of you paying this back and all that. They'll grant you the mortgage because the bank knew that you is something that is achievable.
Okay,
now,
yeah.
The house is like 1.6 average. Like one in London, like I'll say average probably is probably 700,000. What bank will grant you a thing with the way the world is so dynamic now? They know how people's mind works.
No, definitely.
They're not happy with our job. Let's change it.
Yeah,
change circumstances change. That's why even when you're taking credit out, they ask you, is anything going to change with your income?
Your income circumstances. what do they think people are going to say? Yeah, might be broke tomorrow.
The reason why is. If anything happens and you call the whatever provider it is and you say, yeah, but I didn't know, like I changed my jobs and things, but they'll be like, yeah, but you ticked the box.
Yeah, but I didn't know, you know, I didn't know this was gonna happen.
Tick the box.
Do you mean I ticked the box? Yeah, but I ticked the box at the time because my situation was different.
Tick the box, innit?
Wow. You still have to give me my credit though.
You tick the box. Maybe we can work around customer service, you know, but we're not going to give you everything because simply because you tick the box. You know, but yeah, the quarter life crisis
is real, man. Do you feel like most of it is tied to work and money? I feel like a lot of us aren't getting to pursue what we actually want to do because we're stuck in situations in which we're forced to work because we need money. Do you know what I mean? A lot of us probably have different goals, dreams and ambitions, but our jobs are just, I don't know, man, not really even related to it.
You just got to try and make money multiply, man.
That's the secret, isn't it?
What's going on now is like debt is being multiplied.
But debt is being multiplied, bro.
Debt is being multiplied. We're all these loans and bailouts and all that stuff, it's only making things worse, man.
Who do you think is in more debt than our age group or like the older age group?
I don't even know, man. Because this debt, yeah, has probably been piling up from then, you know, and it's only now the bubble's not even burst, bro. It's only now that gas is starting to come out.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Come winter, might get crazy out here, man.
Hey, if you'll pardon the pun, gas is starting to come out of it. Did you get it?
What?
When I said, the bubble ain't burst yet, but gas is starting to come out of it.
What?
It's an economic crisis.
My light jokester.
Obviously.
Okay, go on, get your phone.
Are you fucking blind? You can't see me.
I crashed.
You crashed? How are you coming fast? Why are you fucking coming fast?
This hour, Italy, the Amalfi Coast.
Yeah.
Your money has to be low.
Yeah.
Maybe it'll be nice.
Yeah. I know. I'm gonna wear this.
This is why she said it.
Two hands?
No.
Let's use one hand.
Yeah. Alright. Is it all secure?
Make it all done. What are you doing?
I make it all the same.
What kind of shape is this? No.
Just put it back to how it was.
There we go. Sorry, my bad, man. Shit.
It's wild, man. But yeah. It's easy to feel like you're depressed though, isn't it? But are you really depressed or are you just sad? You know what I mean? What is it to be depressed though?
I don't even know, man.
Do you know what I mean?
It's the most complicated.
Yeah.
It's a proper psychological thing.
Man. Yeah, man.
Because people go like, to the extreme of actually killing themselves.
Yeah, because of depression, bro.
Just avoid that.
I think it's a mindset no one can understand other than the person that's feeling the feeling. Do you know what I mean? It's probably so hard for them to even explain it to people.
It's the fact that every atom and every cell in your body has the desire to live. Like you can be, bro, we're inches from death when we're on the train platform.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But the fact that we don't jump on it because we know we don't want to die.
We all have to fight for survival, innit?
But
it's in us.
The chemical compound of someone that's depressed, it's crazy, man.
Oh, swear down.
Yeah, man. Because to kill yourself is a big thing, you know.
It is, man.
Listen, there's initiations. Do you know what I'm saying? Like the fact that you you're walking to the place where you're going to do it, there's a lot of thoughts that go over because your primitive self will say, no, you want to live.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying?
But maybe they've just reached a point where, you know, when you're just, I don't know, that's what I'm saying, it must be hard to explain, like a point of being just in a state of like such despair and probably loneliness, you know what I'm saying, that you just feel like, what is the point of still being here or something like that? Do you know what I mean?
It's a challenge, man.
It's hard to even, it's probably just mad to even explain it. But hey, life has a habit of pushing people down, I guess.
Life be challenging, man.
Life be challenging, bro. What do you say the hardest thing about life is? About adult life?
Death.
You went straight to the end conclusion.
It's not even that, man.
Death is always there, though.
Listen, yeah, when you're a kid, yeah, you're not exposed to that much of it.
Mm.
One, because your parents show it to you, and it's not so direct.
Yeah.
But now, because you're aging,
what do you think your first memory of death is? When you first knew what death was?
Bro, I don't think I still know what death is, man.
No, I mean, like, when you first realised that people die.
I actually can't remember.
Mine was from, you know, have you ever watched the film Who Framed Roger Rabbit?
No.
There's a bit in the film, man, like the main villain, like he melts in it, and they think he dies or some shit. I don't know, for the first time I clocked that, he can't come back from that. You know what I mean? Yeah. What's going to happen to him now? Then that's when I realised, oh yeah, that's what death is.
What is this fucking hair? Why are you coming fast? I just hit, you hit me, and I just hit the car with my hat. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Lad, you've already given up. You dropped one.
But you know what?
Not J1 yet. Director. You know what? Director of the field day.
Alright. Oh! What happened?
Shoulders, knees, toes, head. Okay.
I remember none of that stuff. Yeah, maybe they spoke to me then, but I've just never been able to comprehend it.
Comprehend death.
It's just something that I just find so confusing, man.
Mm.
So why this in the first place then?
Why put us through all this? But this is what I'm saying. Maybe this is just level one, innit? Then once you die, you go to the next stage and you see Wagwan up there. Wagwan in the next realm.
Remember, imagine if we're just a simulation of another human being.
This is what I'm saying, man. We're just someone playing a sim, like we're a sim character.
Literally, I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah. I think the most maddest thing about being human is thoughts, bruv. Because that's the one thing nobody else can ever tell you about because they're mine. Do you know what I mean? But are they yours or is it someone else putting them into our brains and saying, you do this, you do that, you do this? Like, what if we're being played by someone? Do you know what I mean? Because sometimes, don't you feel like you make a decision that inside you, you know, nah, this I shouldn't do this. This doesn't make sense. Yeah, yeah. But you still end up doing it. What if that's, you know what I'm saying, some different power forcing you to do it? It's mad, isn't it?
Imagine it's that person clicking.
Yeah, they're clicking, go left, and you're saying, ah, I don't want to go left. What are you doing?
This person banging on the map. Yeah. I look up to my person, like, why have you got me on logic one or logic two, man? Why don't you have me like an astronaut?
Bro, I'm looking at my player thinking, bro, Wagwan, you should have clocked this game by now, man. You're shit at this.
Different expansion packs.
Trust me, you need to get some cheat codes, bro.
Different expansion packs, that's when you can work for NASA and all that stuff.
Oh man, that's mad, bro.
Came to the yard after, continue conversation, background music, rubber glass bar, Guinness on the side, pier, frizzler and tobacco. As the eyes got red, beaver juice upon the chatter. Feel upon each other,
yeah, got a wet and sticky front of fruit that twist funny, like. That was funny. But yeah, episode 8 in the bag. We'll see you again in the next one. We'll catch you in episode 9. You know where it goes by now. Gonna pass you over to my brother, Cranberry Juice. To leave us off with our parting message.
Listen, this time we're living in today, you know, for a minute we must think. Opinions do not define our reality. Just read it and weep it and deep it. That'll be all for today. Tune into the next episode. That's it. Thank you. And that should be all. Have a peaceful day. Cheers. Cheers.
How I touch you, my one. When all is said and done, you will believe God is one. And today, I feel it at midnight, feeling that you can't find my one. Lingers when we're done, you will believe God is one. I don't wanna waste no time, yeah. You ain't got a one track mind, yeah. Have it any way you like it. And I can tell that you know I know how I'm on it. Ain't nobody else can relate. Boy, I like it you ain't afraid. Baby, take my hand and let's pray. Telling you the way I like it, how I'm on it, yeah. I could be all the things you told me not to be. You try to come for me, I keep on flourishing. You see the universe in an accompany. It's all in me. You love it how I move you. Love it how I touch you, my one. When all is said and done, you believe God is one. And today, feeling it to midnight, feeling that you can't find my one. Lingers when we're done, you believe God is a woman.
I'll just stop it there. I think I went over.
Yo, listen. Stepped outside and she was walking by. Usually zoned out, but she caught my eye. My eyes looking at them thighs and then she looked surprised. She said, you're all the same. I replied, I ain't surprised. With them looks, mama do 180s, like left foot's connected. Like bodies in bed when the sex good. Interesting.